Hi, in this video we are going to see the PhD admission notification from one of the state university. So here there is All India PhD entrance test guys, and eligibility is if you are having only post graduation you may apply, or else if you are having the UGC NET assistant professor only you may apply for this one, or else UGC NET JRF or the CSIR NET JRF also you may apply for this one guys. So here opportunity are there for all the candidates to apply for the PhD admission notification in the state university. And coming to the fellowships, the candidates who qualified the UGC NET JRF, they are going to get the fellowship from the University Grants Commission. Okay, so that is as usual, and this university is providing the fellowship to the candidates who qualified UGC NET assistant professor only and without JRF. So the amount you are going to get is 28,000 rupees per month. Okay, and along with this one, the contingency is also available. And the candidates who qualified for the UGC NET JRF, they are exempted from the entrance test and they have to directly attend for the interview guys. So please share this video to your friends or colleagues who are looking for such type of PhD admission notifications in the state university. And to get the more notifications like this, please subscribe the channel and then tap the bell icon. Before going into the main content of this video, here one small announcement is that Unacademy is starting the complete courses for the NTA UGC NET preparation from 1st May 2021 onwards. So here the electronic science candidates, the complete batch is going to start from 12th May 2021 onwards. So all the interested candidates may take the subscription plan guys. The links are kept at the description box of this video, and for more details you may watch at the end of this video. Into the present content of the video, it is Sri Mata Vaishno Devi University. So it is a state university guys, and from this one here we got the admission notification for the PhD as well as undergraduation and the post graduation. So you may check down, first we will check down the admission notice and then we will go into the admission brochure guys. So it is a notice released by this state university, and you may check down admission notice 2021 to 22. So fresh applications are invited for the admission to the following programs: BTech as well as MTech and few post graduation programs, and for the PhD. Okay, so PhD offered in various schools of university, and you may check down here the last date. So SMVDU entrance examination 2021 will be conducted for admission to the various UG, PG integrated programs and PhD, for which the last date for submission of online application form is as below. So for the PhD, the last date for submission of online application form is 10th July 2021. And if you want to fill up the online application forms, then here the link is provided, and I will provide all the available links in the description box of this video. So you need not to search separately in the Google guys, right? And coming to the admission brochure, where all the details are clearly mentioned in this one. So this brochure is having the total 81 pages are there, which is mentioning the undergraduation, post-graduation, okay, PhD, all the complete details are mentioned here, but I will show you the details regarding only the PhD. So for that one, first we will go to the 17th page, and in this 17th page they mention the eligibility criteria for admission to the PhD program in various schools. So first of all, here you may check down from which departments the PhD admission is released in this university: computer science and engineering, electronics and communication engineering, mechanical engineering, physics, biotechnology or chemistry, business, energy management, mathematics, economics and philosophy. So if you belong to these departments, then you may proceed this. And if you don't belong to these departments, then please share this video to your friends or colleagues who belongs to these departments. It will be very much helpful to them. And a candidate for admission to the PhD program on full-time registration basis must have master's degree in engineering or technology or sciences or management or humanities and social sciences or an interdisciplinary or transdisciplinary with minimum CGPA 6.75, or else the CGPA of 6.00, or else the 60% of marks aggregate if of any university established by law or interdisciplinary research, okay, that means from your college. And apart from this one, the candidates who are applying for the full-time PhD, those candidates also must have qualified national level examination such as UGC or CSI or NET or the GATE in concerned discipline, or should be sponsored by a reputed organization where he or she is working. Okay, however, candidates who are not qualified for the national eligibility test or the national level entrance test, on full-time registration basis for which they may be considered in case of leftover seats. However, such candidate shall not get any type of assistantship from the university. That means if you are having only post-graduation, you may apply for this one. Okay, if you are sponsoring by so many reputed organizations where you are working, but in that case you don't get any type of assistantship, guys. Okay, if you qualified for the national level entrance examinations or the national level test, then only you will be qualified for the getting the assistantship from this university. Fine. So these are the eligibility conditions, so you may please check down once. Okay, and few more conditions are also given here regarding the sponsored candidates and all these things. And after the 17th page, and the next one is the 21st page, that is the selection criteria of the PhD. So the eligible candidate shortlisted for admission process to PhD program in each school undergo the following selection procedure. The shortlisting of applications for the purpose of admission test or interview shall be done by the concerned school research committee, and PhD students shall be required to go through an entrance test conducted by the SRC of the school. And candidates who qualified the UGC NET, JRF, UGC CSIR NET, JRF, SLET or GATE, or teacher fellowship, or else have passed the MPhil program, may be exempted from appearing for the written test. Okay. Next, coming to the entrance test, shall be qualifying in nature. Okay, with qualifying marks of 50%. The syllabus of the entrance test shall consist of 50% of research methodology and 50% of the work. Subject specific will be there, and the candidates who qualify for the written test, they are going to attend the interview or the viva voice. Fine. So these are the details, guys. And the next one is the 29th page. Okay, so in the 29th page you may check down for PhD students, UGC NET assistant professor only and GATE qualified PhD students of this university eligible for registering on a full-time basis shall be eligible for the assistantship of 25,000 rupees per month for first 2 years and 28,000 rupees per month for next 1 year, along with the 12,000 rupees per year of contingency you will get for initial 2 years, and a total of 25,000 rupees for the third year. Okay, or till the time he or she submit the PhD thesis. Fine. So here fellowship is going to get to the candidates who are qualified for the assistantship, meaning UGC NET assistant professor only. Okay, and for only PG candidates here, there are no stipends, guys. Okay, so these are the details regarding the PhD out of this entire brochure. Okay, so I will provide all the necessary links in the description box of this video. So you please just once go through that one, guys, and you will get the lot of information. And please share this video to your friends or colleagues who are looking for such type of opportunities. It will be very much helpful to them. And to get the more notifications like this, please subscribe the channel and then tap the bell icon. And the candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET exam, here one announcement follows. So listen, guys. Hi friends, my name is Ashwini Kumar, Unacademy educator. So all of you know that Unacademy is India's largest learning platform, and it is providing the very good content to the learners who are preparing for the competitive examinations. And from this video, I want to bring you one notice that I am going to start the two new courses for the UGC NET candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET exam in 2021. So the course number one is complete course for the NTA UGC NET paper one, that is teaching and research aptitude. So that it is going to start from November 9th onwards. And coming to the paper 2 is electronic science. So the complete course for the electronic science is going to start from November 10th onwards. So the interested candidates may take the subscription plan of the Unacademy, that I will show you the different types of subscription plans. But before going to those subscription plans for the paper 1 and as well as to the paper 2, one thing that I want to share you is that if you want to check how the lectures will be, and why, because each and everybody is having some dilemma that before taking the subscription plans, that whatever the content I am going to teach you, so how the content I am going to give you, so whether you can able to understand or not. So for that purpose, I will provide my Unacademy profile link in the description box of this video, guys. So if you click on that one, then you will be directed to this web page. So here, if you scroll down, you can check the special classes. So special classes means these are the completely free classes. So every month I'm going to take the free classes to the candidates. So if you click on this see all, then all my special classes that you can check down here, right? So if you click on these classes, then whatever the video classes I took at that date and time, so those videos will play. So with the help of these videos, you can decide that how I am going to deliver the content of the concepts and each and everything. So based upon that one, you may take the subscription plans, guys. Okay. And if you want to check that how I am going to teach the UGCNET paper 1, that is Teaching and Research Aptitude. So it is my official YouTube channel link for the paper 1 that you can check down. I will provide this link also in the description box of this video. So here I did the complete unit 1, that is the teaching aptitude here by taking the total 6 parts. So it will be acts like the reference to you that how I am going to teach you, whether you can able to understand or not. So by looking all this content, that means the electronic science from the Unacademy app and from the YouTube channel, you can guess that how I am going to teach the paper 1. So by looking all these things, you can decide.